Welcome to another video from Far North Bushcraft and Survival. I am really glad that you joined us. And in this video, I'm going to show you how something as simple as what I have in my hands can save your life. It can both shelter you and warm you up. Okay, let's just pretend that we are in a survival scenario. Here goes. I don't recognize any of this. I've been looking and looking and looking, trying to find my way out. I just got to admit that I'm lost. And I don't know how to get out. It's just about dark. I better find a place to hunker down. I better look for a place to hunker down. Okay, right here, I see a creek. Not a creek, but gully. So I know that cold is going to settle down in this gully and flow like a river downward. Here is a little ridge, a little raise in the ground. That's good. I don't want to be on top of a ridge because that'll be open to the breeze. So I'm going to look for a place here that I like. Okay, let's see. Over here. This looks, I like this better. Here's a good tree. I'm going to use this tree right here. It leans back at the trunk there a little bit. That'll be a little more comfortable. Over there's a spruce tree, and I need those spruce boughs. What I need to do is insulate me from the ground, get me up off of the ground. It wouldn't hurt to have a little bit of insulation behind me as well to separate me from that cold wood. Okay, I think I like that. All right, let me give it a try. Excellent. Now, I'm looking for a piece of bark, and yes, this should work. Excellent, right here. Okay. I need to go back to the shelter site. Okay, now the shelter. This is a garbage bag, a construction garbage bag. This is 2 mil. Now there is also a 55 gallon barrel drum liners. I don't know, maybe those are a little bit wider might be better. It depends on the person using it. Okay, now here's the halfway fold. Let's just verify that. Okay, right there is halfway. So I'm gonna make a slit about 6 inches, 3 inches either side. Okay, good enough. Okay, now I am gonna go about 5 inches down, 4 inches down, and slice up right up the center line. There is our shelter. Now it looks like it might rain, but that's okay actually, because we will be totally sheltered. Now, you can see how I made this right here. Okay. Now, if you ever use this method of survival, be very aware of the potential fire hazard. I will accept no responsibility for your, if you fail to exercise common safety protocol in a situation like this. So these are two tea candles. I melted wax and poured them around it. Let's get them lit up. Okay, I am entirely sheltered. I hope you can hear me. I am entirely sheltered. I am comfortable. And it can rain, it can be cold, but I'm heated and protected from the elements. Now, let's see just how good this does. Okay, it's been about 15 minutes or so, and the temperature has come up quite a bit in here. Also, it started raining just a little bit, and then it quit again. But with a hat like this, like I'm wearing, and a shelter like this, it could rain all it wanted to, and it wouldn't bother me a bit. I'm totally sheltered from the rain.
Now, this is not going to warm your back, because the garbage bag is tight against your back, so the warm air cannot gain access. So a couple things you can do to make this warmer is you could have three tea candles in there, so have three flames burning. You might have to trim the candle so that they fit. Another thing you could do is not use the tea candles because their wicks are so small. Use a larger wick. Use larger wicks. Another thing you could do is wrap a space blanket, Mylar, around you with leave it loosely around your shoulders. That would help hold in some heat. Do that outside of the garbage bag.
Now, you don't want to move around a lot. Every time you move this here, it's going to pump. It's going to pump the warm air out and cold air in. So, you know, remain as calm as possible. Get in a fairly comfortable position and remain that way as long as you can. You may have to get up, you know, I don't know, once every hour, once every 2 hours, get up and walk around for a little bit and then come back, sit back down. Be conscious of those candles burning underneath of there, though. You may want to put them out before you stand up. Well, I've got a temperature sensor inside the shelter with me. There, what you're looking at, where it says outside is actually inside, and where it says inside is actually outside. It's 91 in the shelter right now, and I believe it's 57, 58 outside. Now, if you want to be even warmer, if you double bag, use two garbage bags, it should be even warmer. I wouldn't be surprised if somebody in the comments will say, well, who carries garbage bags with them and candles? Well, hopefully after seeing this video, maybe you might decide that you need to carry a garbage bag and candles and be prepared. That's the purpose of this video, is to help you be a little more aware, be prepared. Well, thanks for joining Connie and I. We really appreciate you folks. And we also want to say we especially appreciate those who have donated to the channel. We appreciate it, even every little bit. Thanks for joining us. We'll see you on the next video. You folks have a good one and take care.
If you enjoyed this video, be sure and give it a thumbs up and to share it, as well as subscribe so you don't miss any more. And check out these suggested videos here. Thank you.